Good evening, dear past presidents, council members, representatives of the family of late engineer E.O.E. Pereira, Vice Chancellor, University of Peradeniya, members and guests. You all are welcome for Professor E.O.E. Pereira Memorial Oration. Could you kindly stand up to welcome the presidential procession? Please be seated. It is a time to light up the traditional oil lamp. I cordially invite President of ISL, Engineer Jayavilal Meyagoda, Engineer Professor Niranjani Ratnayaka, Past President Engineer Newton Vikram Surya, Engineer B.R. Robert Fernando, Engineer Professor Ranjit Disanayaka, guest speaker, a representative of the family of late engineer E.O.E. Pereira, Professor Upul Disanayaka, Vice Chancellor, University of Peradeniya, Engineer Lalit Pallegama, Secretary Civil Engineer within a sectional committee, Engineer Harsha Kumar Surayarachi, member civil engineering sectional committee, ISL, to light up the traditional oil. Thank you very much. Please be seated. Dear President, ISL, I now cordially invite you to garland the photograph of Professor E.O.E. Pereira. Dear President, thank you very much. Please be seated. Now, welcome addressed by Engineer Jayavilal Meyagoda, President ISL. Say it's over to you.
Hi everyone, not a very good evening, but I will say good evening. Professor Ranjit Sanayaka, our guest speaker today, speaker for the memorial lecture. Professor Upal Sanayaka, Vice Chancellor, University of Peradeniya. Past presidents, council members, ISL members, relatives of family of Professor E.O.E. Pereira, and media, and other invitees. The Institution of Engineers Sri Lanka, being the apex professional body for engineers and committed towards uplifting the profession to the best international standards, commemorates birth anniversaries of engineering greats the country has produced. Professor E.O.E. Pereira, father of modern engineering education in Sri Lanka, was born on 30th September 1907 and received his education at the Royal College, where he excelled in both academics and sports. He won the Soysa Science Prize, the Muhammad Ali Arithmetic Prize, and Iwam's Prize for Mathematics. In 1928, he entered the University College Colombo and graduated with a first class honours degree from the University of London, gaining first place in the Faculty of Engineering and winning a scholarship. The scholarship enabled him to enter Downing College, Cambridge, where he gained the distinction of being the only graduate to finish the three-year degree in 2 years. From the University of Cambridge, he graduated with first class honours in Mechanical Engineering. He served in the Department of Public Works for 15 years before joining the teaching staff of the University of Ceylon in 1946. Considered as the father of modern engineering education in the country, Professor E.O.E. Pereira was responsible for putting in place the foundations on which higher education in engineering in Sri Lanka is built upon today. Called upon to provide leadership when the country decided to educate its engineers in its own soil, he had to literally start from scratch in establishing the first Faculty of Engineering. At first, in temporary settings, starting at the Ceylon Technical College, Mardana, and then in a shed at Thurston Road premises, now University of Colombo, and then its permanent place at Peradeniya. The fact that the University of London decided to withdraw its external BSc Engineering degree, being conducted up to that time at the Ceylon Technical College, made the task entrusted to him all the more daunting. Not only did he have to hurriedly scramble the necessary academic staff, but also attend to the acquiring of the most appropriate equipment for the laboratory that was being built at the new faculty, while also overcoming the administrative hurdles thrown across his path. He achieved his goal successfully as the Dean of the Faculty of Engineering for 2 decades before he was given the Vice Chancellorship of that university, as the crown in glory speaks volumes of his greatness. The title Vidyajyoti was conferred on him in 1986 in due recognition of his services to the nation. Engineering education today has many challenges. It has to foster the right type of skills, attitudes and behavior that will lead to sustainable and inclusive growth while preserving the environment. The theme of this year's memorial lecture, Green Entrepreneurship, a Promising Path Towards a Sustainable Future, touches upon this and other issues that are pushing engineering education towards new frontiers requiring creative thinking and integrated approach. Today's Professor E.O.E. Pereira Memorial Lecture, delivered by Professor Ranjit Sanayaka, Professor in Civil Engineering, University of Peradeniya. Professor Sanayaka was a Fulbright Scholar in Columbia University, USA, and Fellow in Monash University, Australia. He was awarded Young Scientist Award 2007 for Excellence in Scientific Research by National Science and Technology Commission of Sri Lanka, and Overseas Prize for the paper published in Institution of Civil Engineers, London. He was awarded Australia Alumni Excellence Award in 2012. He has published over 140 papers. He has chaired 7 international conferences. He is presently the chairman of the Green Building Council of Sri Lanka and also a founder member of it. Over to you, Professor Ranjit Sanayaka.
Good evening. ISL President Dalal Meegoda, Vice Chancellor, University of Pereira, Prof. Pulmidusanayaka, Past President of the ESL, Council Members, Fellow Engineers. It is a great pleasure that I was invited to deliver a memorial lecture this year on behalf of Engineer Prof. E.A. Pereira. Just at the beginning of my presentation, as though Engineer Meegoda explained, I have few slides on Professor E.O. Pereira. We consider him as a father of engineering education in Sri Lanka. He mentioned the father of modern engineering education in Sri Lanka. I think this is true. Some of them as we consider as a father of engineering education in Sri Lanka. He is a founder dean of College of Engineering, then he became the Vice Chancellor. Then the academic excellence in he built as a dean over the 20 years enabled thousands of engineers to excel in various fields. We are eternally grateful to him for his leadership and the guidance that made us what we are today. I would like to take you to the University of Pereira with few slides. Recently, it is named as one of the 10 beautiful universities in the world. Some of the slides from the University of Pereira to show it is beauty. This is the Agba Bridge which crossed the wet zone to dry zone. This is we can see from the Antara Mountain, closer view. You might see that it is not so dry. This is the E.O. Pereira Theatre, still the one of the best theatre that we have in the packet. The student, after the graduation, say they still enjoy the pre-education facilities that we have in the University of Pereira, thanks to Professor E.O. Pereira. Let's get into my presentation today, Green Entrepreneurships. I'll start with the nation's wealth. I believe hard working of us is a wealth for the nation. Talent of us is the wealth for the nation. Enterprises is the wealth, innovation is the wealth. But end of my presentation, you will realize that not the just entrepreneurship, green entrepreneurship is the one we need for the wealth of the country. In conclusion, I will add little bit more to this one. Please bear with me. As we are engineers, it is, we realize, many people realize, it's a big step from engineer to entrepreneur. Reason behind that and why less people are going toward the entrepreneurships, where the many people would like to go the path of engineers. Some of the world engineers, Bill Gates, and the local engineers like RN, there are many engineers like this matter. Engineer who design, build and maintain engines, machines or the structure. Right? But when you go to an entrepreneur, it's a bit smarter than engineer. Where you might see the sacrifice, his life to build something, take risk, hard work, is smart, professional, and he's becoming his own employer. Right. Likewise, there are certain qualities, and very importantly, the taking this risk to go from the engineer to the entrepreneurship system, the most difficult part that we don't take. again the entrepreneur make things happen. So you see the difference. But once you become entrepreneur, to become a green entrepreneur is not a difficult one, and it is a must, you will realize. Just to explain about the green entrepreneurships is a concept that opens up the new opportunities for the business, job creation and environmental innovation. Enterprises play a key role in open market economy as a driver of change by demonstrating the economic benefit that come from the being green. They act as a pull factor, encouraging the other companies to come proactive to go green. A person, an entrepreneur, who will consider environment, social, economy, these three pillars together become a green entrepreneur. So I have a very nice slide in order to explain what is the entrepreneurships and the green entrepreneurs. Please carefully look at this one. I hope you will realize importance of this. So this is where our cities are: Colombo, Kandy, dust, smoke, you name anything and everything. You hate to go. What has happened? We at the beginning, you can remember that I told the national wealth is entrepreneur. But if entrepreneur was doing this change, you cannot accept this one. This is we call as a business as usual model. In the case of business as usual model, cities are becoming so. The development is this one. But we don't want it. World don't want it. We have a lot of problem. I'm not going to talk about the carbon dioxide emission, dust, that and this. Many, many problems are there. Environment problems. Whole world is talking right now. We need to have a transformation. The built environment to the sustainable built environment. We would like to see, world is would like to see the environment like this one. So this can be transformed only through the green entrepreneurships. That means to transfer from this to this, billions of new business opportunities are created. As well as almost all the businesses, they are running on business as usual, have to be changed into the green entrepreneurships, then only you will be able to see the sustainable built environment. Green, we being engineers, what we, green is a big topic, but we being engineers, I name it as engineers green, right? We believe that we need to have the sustainable sites. So these we call as sustainable sites. Again, we need to have water efficiency. Water efficiency. We need to have energy efficiency, green energy and so on. We need to have the material resources where are green. We need to have the indoor environment. So this is what we are talking about as engineers. If you want to make the world green, we have to tackle. By looking at this one, you can create the millions of new businesses that should be green businesses. So that is a green entrepreneurship should be there. When I'm talking about the green entrepreneurships, there are two economical models: linear economic model and circular economic model. This is very important because the green entrepreneurship is enable to transform from the linear economic to circular economic. The most important is saving the environment. Let me explain what these two models are. Very easy to understand. Linear mean that we get the resources from the earth crust, we produce something, we distribute it, we consume it, waste it. You get it sand, you get it cement, you get anything and everything, get and after 10 years, 100 years, we waste it. Right? This is what happened. So, in picture basis. Let me explain it. Around the world, we are getting the material. We build the thing. Supermarket, roads, you name it. End of the day, we demolish it. And you might see on the road So this is the linear model. The results of the linear model is this. This is the results of the linear model. Dust, smoke, carbon dioxide emission, everything part of the this linear economy. Everything that you say as bad is well indicators. Everything say that the, because of the linear economy, humidity is increasing, temperature, you name anything and everything getting increased, getting worse for human being. This is a part of the linear economy. Go to the construction where I am coming from, where most of you are part of it. Construction is not an eco-friendly business activity at all. But it is a part of the linear economy right now today. So we have to make sure how I am going to make sure, I'll let you know. We cut the trees, we burn them and level it, erosion, demolition, all structures and put into the on the roads, all the dust are washed away to the stream, dust is going on the road, construction, sand are bringing from the far away, breaking the roads and breaking the structure, water table, producing the whatever we want, sand, the tile, cement and everything. For this we need a solution. Having a green entrepreneurship, we call it a greener building. So greener building is the, through the greener building, whatever the photograph that you saw so far, we say not to do that, minimize it, right? Not to disturb the land, save the, use the green material and so forth. This is the concept of green building, not to do what you see as bad. We are keeping the nature, bringing the social and economics into the picture. In usual case, what happens is the nature will be forget, we bring the social and economic. Like in the construction of Gamudawa and various other situations where we never think about the nature. We only think about the economy and social problems. That won't work. Business as usual is dead. You cannot do anymore. Green growth is the answer to the both our climatic and the economic problem. That is realized around world. We'll go to the circular economy very quickly. Circular economy is the way you get the raw material, design and production, distribution, consumption, collection and recycle and coming. But there is always the residual part. This is where researchers have to make sure that the, how can we reduce this residual part. That is the part of the green research. Where the same material will be taken carefully and we go for the greener building using that material that we are not going to demolish end of the day, no to demolition. We have to go for the reuse, recycle, all the other words that we use under that, right? That have to be under the circular economy. National economy. What has happened to the national economy? National economy is running on the linear economic model. Look at this diagram. What has happened? All the time, day by day, what is happening? More and more import, less and less export. There you cannot have sustainable development. This is how it is happening. You have to make it opposite. That can be done through the green entrepreneurships. Green entrepreneurship is the way forward to develop the national economy. Export, increase the export, reduce the import. This is the model that we want through the, see some of the situation. Where we are very proud to say that the tea, rubber, coconut. Where is the world market? Global market is captured by electronic, IT, telecommunication, this is the, this is where we have to tackle it. But some of the market already has gone. We missed the bus. That is whatever available you can see. See some of the things, resources available. What we are doing, these resources, titanium dioxide, we use 65% of the use of the paint industry. I'm not expert on this subject, but just to tell you that the, our expenditure for the only for the paint industry is 12.5. Just by numbers, our income by selling the raw material is 8, the potential income is 100 million. We have been doing this and this is a kind of lean economy. We are just sending the raw material but importing the material. So the under the green economic, green entrepreneurships, we have to have the value addition for this. See the real model, Chinese economy. They have realized from the beginning, far away, first of thing that they realize is that they understand what their resources is. Then in order to value, give a value to the resources, they identify the next the expert. They started from there. Otherwise, just over the night, they cannot come to this level. They carefully understand their resources, they identify the expert, gave them the better opportunity, create the value addition. Today, they are here not because of anything else, they understand the green entrepreneurship, they realize it, they work on it. But green entrepreneurships can be a very small way in a big way. So when you look at this diagram, one can see the green entrepreneurship. This pellet has been used for the furniture. When you look at here, somebody can propose the greener model. Look at so many vehicles are on the street, right? But having a public transportation system, we can reduce it. That has become a green entrepreneurship. When you go to the next one, this from the recycling market itself, world can create the so many new industries, green industries. So many people can be employed here. So this become a greener enterprise. Home delivery. How many people are working, have to go and bring the things, and if somebody identified, somebody can supply it, it become a smaller way, green entrepreneurships. Planting. See, somebody has innovative to think about the use the land that has a many benefit. It reduce the operation. This land is not used for something else that it has been used. So this kind of innovative idea can be green entrepreneur. If you go to the net, there are so many new innovative ideas is there. Just let me share with you some of the my personal experience and how myself has applied the green entrepreneurships to some of the work that I have been doing in last 10-15 years. This is very recent initiative. This is Noratchole power plant. Experts say Noratchole power plant has already paid back its investment. That is true. What is happening in Noratchole? This is a coal power plant. We are beating the coal and dumping in Noratchole. And this is Noratchole plant again. We get the power. Recently, I visited few times. I heard that the last year megawatt, something like the 5 rupees, 5.5 or something. Very cheap compared to. Right? What is the problem? Fly ash. So, power is good. Fly ash has become a big problem. Most of you may know that. That is there. That is day by day. It is becoming a big problem. Some other problems also there. As I explained before, sand prices, material shortage. Day by day, prices of the sands are going, many, many problems are there. Labor shortage are there. That means the problem in the fly ash, material shortage, labor shortage. There are many other problems related to this. So, what we decided with two of my students, so we thought of establish a company called Lanka AAC Private Limited. What we are trying to do is bring down the plant from India, where we are going to use the fly ash, cement, lime to produce a brick, right? It is, I am not going to explain with the process, but at the end of the day you end up with the,
a brick.
So this not only brick, rest of the material parts also can be. For the time being, we are going to start the brick manufacturing plant. That is, this is the brick. Lightweight, strength is good. It is very good for the, especially for the high-rise building construction. So, for that will partly solve the labor shortage, neatness, the plastering and so forth is very easy. As you see there, in India, it's highly used in the high-rise construction. It is used around the world. It's not a new technology. It is a proven technology. It is available in the world. So we are going to bring it to the Sri Lanka. The plant will be established in Putlam. Will be able to produce the bricks within 3 months. This is Lanka AAC Private Limited. So another work that I have done, sustainable design and construction. Just briefly explain you the problem I was given. One end limestone, the other end is a Putlam factory that was at that time owned by the Holcim Lanka Limited. So that is around 43 kilometers. I am not going to talk about why it is 43 and why they build the factory in Putlam. This is the political sustainability. Because if we have the political sustainability, factory would have built in, they are not here. But anyway, that is done. So they have a problem. They had an old logo motto and they are going to go for the new one. So they worried about the failure of the some of the bridge in between, as you see there. So this is the simple problem. So they are going to change the old one to new one. New one is heavier than old one. They worried about there are some 5 bridges on the way. They worried about the that might there will be a problem. So I was consulted. My specialization is in the condition assessment of the structures and the bridges. So we did the assessment. In the assessment, we found that the one bridge is very poor. So then at the beginning, they want to go up with the new bridge, but I tried to say that why not you repair the bridge? But they say that no, we want to go up with the new bridge. Then we say that okay, we'll go up with the new bridge. So we design for the new bridge, and once the design is completed, I explain them, if you want to go for the new bridge, the blue will be the cost that you have to bear. If you go for the rehabilitation, repair, retrofitting, cost can be half. As you know that the money works, money talks, anyway, they accepted the repair. They withdraw the idea of new one. So we allow them to rethink about the whole process of what they want to do. And the same gentleman who wanted to go for the new bridge decided to go for the retrofitting. So for this work, I have established a company for this work called International Center for the Sustainable Built Environment Private Limited with my student. So we operate Kandy and Colombo. So there we mainly many consultancy works are there. We are highlighted is green consultancy and the structural health monitoring. These are purely green work. So there by going for the rehabilitation, repair work, retrofitting, reduce the carbon dioxide emission, right? So this is the repair work. I'm going very fast, just grab it. So this is the foundation. This is the completion of the foundation work. By doing the foundation, bridge is been under repair. So you might see that I didn't tell you the story. We are going to bring the bridge to here. It was there because in 1978 it was subject to the cyclone. Bridge was washed off. That was placed in the temporary place, but later they want to bring it to the new place. Anyway, we repair this, straighten the road, and we jack up the bridge as you see there. You see the jacking up the bridge, there is 70 ton. After the jacking up, bridge is going to be pulled by the chain block to the 10 meter. So it took almost 12 hours, but anyway, finally we could bring the bridge to the new location. Why we use for the very primitive technology there? Because we are working in the jungle, there is no roads and so forth. of a very primitive technology was used to bring the bridge for the old location, new location. So just to show that the bridge was something like this before, now it is to the present location, right? Our bridge was completed. So you might see that the first bridge is passing through the road. So this is the day of opening, right? You might see who is opening the bridge. They were kind enough to invite me to open the bridge. They are very happy about our work. So this is the opening day. This is the sustainable construction. That construction was done by the, again one of my first company called Lego International Private Limited. It was established about 18 years before. Now we do a lot of sustainable construction. So this is the bridge. You see that the sustainable construction. There has been a lot of similar bridges, similar structures has been demolished, taken away without proper investigation. In order to promote this sustainability, we have been doing the sustainable built environment conference. Professor Tisan here, he was the one who proposed the name, as I remember, 2010. Last year we had a 7th international conference on sustainable built environment. Next year we are going to have the 9th international conference on sustainable built environment. We used to do it Kandy because there are many activities is happening in Colombo. We want to make it Kandy. And not only that, we have established the Green Building Council of Sri Lanka. We are presently, I'm the chairman there. Professor Payan Mendis was the founder chairman of the Green Building Council, and we have trained a green professional. Nearly 700 green professional has been trained over the last few years. This year we are going to have the 8th International Conference on Structural Engineering and Construction Management, right, that will be held in Kandy. We have been working the Colombo Municipal Council. We are going to go for the MOU this December 20th with the Colombo Municipal Council. Just let me explain some of the local. There are so many local entrepreneurs who do the green entrepreneurships. I'll start with somebody. He's not an engineer. He was working as a Pinko earlier. So Ravi Nissan, he is a pass out from the Pereira in the science faculty. And after working few years, he wanted to establish his own manufacturing plant in Sri Lanka. He took the risk and resigned from the company, started the smaller way. Right now, he is the first local manufacturer of the admixtures. Only export of the local manufactured admixtures, and he said that he covers 75% of the local market and 90% of the market in Colombo. So you see why it is green. He export and reduce the import and the employment generation in the country, usage of the local material and so forth. Another gentleman, he is one of a student, I think he is in the audience. He is started the life as a civil engineer. He worked in the CCB. He was good at the IT, then he moved on to the IT section of the CCB. Later he met this a gentleman, we say so, and he had been having a lot of fun together. One day the gentleman want to have the tailored shirt in Colombo. After the getting it done, he was so happy. But they have discussed, why not when I go back to Sweden, I will send you the email of the requirement, you make it Sri Lanka and send, I'll sell it. They started the smaller way, that is their company, right? When they started, they told me that when the other batchmate asked what I am doing right now, I am doing a tailor shop. They laugh at me because I am different. I laugh at them because they are all the same. But today, recently I visited his factory. As I remember, 400 employees are there. Even the suits that I am wearing, he presented me. He really wanted to present the suits for me. So that's what I had to go to his, give the measurement. And he's right now building the second factory. What they are doing is, they have the web. You can go to the web bank, you can give the, all the measurement. These are the boxes, solo, that many countries, almost every day, they are online. They, people go to the web and give their dimensions, and they make the material, the whatever they want, send to the country through the DHL. So this is the box contain these kind of shirts and so on. I'm not going to go into the detail. You read the people like kapruka.com and people who start the NanoCap, pick me, try to understand how they are really a green entrepreneurships, right? Like a similar entrepreneurships are there, right? Let me explain few international entrepreneurs, right? Uber, right? They say that the world largest taxi company having no taxi, right? How innovative they are, right? Right? Yeah? This is situation. eBay, right? Not only buy the things in the eBay, understand the concept behind this. Why not you create your own business? This is the people who studied and has been to country like Japan, China and so forth. I can remember every year when the student graduated, there are nearly 10,000 bicycle put in here and there, nobody's. And if you go by bicycle, they don't take any money, even if you throw away your purse, but they, if you see a bicycle is unlocked, they take it, go to some other place. This has been a big problem, cities. So they introduced the system called ride and share. So this is the first introduced by the government. So stand is there, you get the bicycle and we have to return to the either this place or the similar place. That didn't work much. But the, another company came with a marvelous idea. This bicycle is connected to GPS. When you go to the phone, you click it, there you will get the number, you can unlock the bicycle, then the company knows the so and so started to use the bicycle. If you use the 1 hour, you lock it, your metro. It is not your bicycle. I was a student in Chengdu. I can't see any personal bicycle in the city. 100% bicycles are provided by the companies. Bicycles are here and there. Even the parking is not a big part. You can park the whole lot together. One by one day, people are taking. Because you don't have to find out where is my bicycle. Because it's nobody's bicycle. That means the people are now not buying bicycle. Bicycles are there in the market. You, if you are, have a mobile number, you can open the bicycle and use it there. How innovative it is, right? It's a green business. Likewise, there, when you go to the Sweden, you see that the, most of the bicycle, the buses are public transport run by the biogas. These kind of things have to be introduced. This is the biogas buses. I'm coming to the my conclusion. I was telling you that at the beginning, nation's wealth, hard work, talent, entrepreneurship. I told you that the, this should be a green entrepreneurship. Then again, I am going to add something. Maybe my new next presentation will be the not only the green entrepreneurship, we should convert to the green innovation. You can do the innovation. This is the innovation process. If this is not going to be the green, no point. You can produce the cheapest building material. But if it is going to harm to the environment, no point of doing it. But the whatever the innovation that you do must be a green innovation. Therefore, for the wealth of the nation should be hard work, talent, entrepreneurship, green innovation. That is for sure. Yeah, it is a big step. But this is the problem. Our people are not taking the enough risk to jump. That's what I sometimes say. Rather than Pereira engineering faculty, we produce 415 engineering students passing out almost every year. But I say that if we can produce the one Bill Gates mature for the country, therefore we need to find out the people who jump out of the box and do the this one. Remember, this slide is very, very important. This is the business as usual. This is what we are doing. So this have to be changed to the green entrepreneurship. Think about today itself. whatever you work. Because if you start the business with the green entrepreneurships, green ideas, day by day demand for that will be increased. Day by day, the material, labor shortage, many problems that we are facing is getting worse, so that the demand for the enterprises will be increased. If you are building, go for the greener building, a smaller way we are possible. We used to say make it happen, now we have to say make it green. Finally, remember Professor E.O. Pereira is the father of engineering education in Sri Lanka. I should say thank you so much.
Thank you very much, Professor Sanayaka, for your resourceful and highly informative speech. We as engineers should also think twice on what we are doing, what we are currently doing. Now I kindly invite President IESL to present a small token of appreciation to Professor Sanayaka. It is the time for vote of thanks. I kindly invite Engineer Harsha Kumar Suryarachi, Member Civil Engineering Sectional Committee.
Yes. Thank you. I think it's all about you all to get ready for the part two of the commemoration lecture, maybe the vote of thanks. President, President-elect, Vice Presidents, Council Members, Guest Speaker, Engineer Professor Ranjit Disanayaka, relatives of Vidyajyoti Engineer Professor E.O. Pereira's family, ladies and gentlemen, it's a great pleasure for me to deliver the vote of thanks at the memorial oration of the great Vidyajyoti engineer Professor E.O. Pereira. Today we mark his 110th birth anniversary as well. I am happy to see here the engineers and others present in numbers to honor Vidyajyoti engineer Professor E.O. Pereira. Vidyajyoti engineer Professor E.O. Pereira was a practical engineer who happened to at some stage teaching for technical students, then went on to institute the first ever engineering faculty in Sri Lanka, giving accessibility to engineering education for perhaps less than 100 students that day, which had already led to many thousands of beneficiaries by today. The secret of Vidyajyoti engineer Professor E.O. Pereira's success should have been his positive attitude and can-go approach. I am sure he too would have had groups pulling his leg, coming up with arguments with popular slogans, but with empty or negative contributions to society. I am not surprised if he had been asked to first improve the advanced level education before instituting an engineering faculty. He would have had to confront people who thought since the A-level education in many schools then did not have mathematics stream, that he was only attempting to serve a handful of privileged. Some would have come up saying he is trying to increase his salary package. Some would have said there is not enough sufficiently trained teachers, so to postpone the idea of having a faculty of engineering. Might also have had to face lot many cries such as not having sufficient laboratories, no demand for engineers in the country, etc. and etc. His bosses up to the governor of the country would have received numerous petitions while he was trying to institute the Faculty of Engineering against him. King of the Great Britain would not have been spared of. Vidyajyoti engineer Professor E.O.E. Pereira had successfully overcome all those, and thanks to his strength, ability and success, today we are here as proud products of many engineering faculties of Sri Lanka universities. For the Vidyajyoti engineer Professor E.O.E. Pereira memorial lecture, we have invited engineer Professor Ranjit Disanayake, who happily accepted our invitation and delivered the lecture on green entrepreneurship, a promising path towards a sustainable future. Since his field of expertise is closely tied to sustainable construction industry, he has selected the topic. Whatever the topic we talk on, engineering is very relevant to Vidyajyoti engineer Professor E.O.E. Pereira. He is the father of engineering education in Sri Lanka. I hope you all enjoyed and benefited from Professor Ranjit Disanayake's lecture. On behalf of ISL, thank you very much, Engineer Professor Ranjit Disanayake, for accepting our invitation and delivering the wonderful lecture today.